Good morning. It's Thursday and it is calm right now before more storms rolling in on Hardneck Farms in historic Guthrie, Oklahoma. And my poor farm, it is looking so bad. All we've had is just rain, flood, tornado warnings, between the wind and the rains and stuff, but kind of tell you about this project. This is my butterfly garden, and it has almost everything a butterfly likes. Oklahoma natives, echinacea. I am going to get my down here, because as you can see, Bermuda is just, you just cannot fight Bermuda. And please excuse this farm, it is a huge mess. You can tell how much rain we've got. Everything is just so saturated. Luckily, most of the garden, even though it's right here in clay soil, tubs are great. If you can get your farmer friends to save them for you, I highly recommend them. They're durable. You can clean up around them. And they just buy little bits. It keeps them on the landfill, which is so important. It just doesn't look good. There is some lettuce growing, but it looks everything to be drowning. I'm so disappointed. I put my heart into this farm. A shovel into it. My husband dumped it with the tractor, and it's not doing too good. All that is Bermuda, and it looks like these sweet peppers are doing pretty good. TLC Gardens in Oklahoma City or Edmond, and I asked, they had green trees, and I asked which variety this was. There's no tag. He said it's an apple. I said, well, I knew it was an apple, but I wanted to know the variety, and he didn't have any answers for me. mystery. I'll sell it to you for $10. And I said, sold. I brought it home, stuck it on the row with the apples. Hey, so my husband designed this garden so that I could drive zero turn up and down the road. And also it would give me walkways in between the varieties I planted. But in Oklahoma, it gets so stinky hot. Trees are great to have in the gardens. And the only problem is you cannot get the zero turned down anymore. And my husband will not weed eat for me. So I had to get a self-propelled mower with a bag. But now it's so tall, I can't even do that. So I'll get to it. It's rest. That's what it looks like, guys. Well, I tried. Grafting. This little baby right here was a Granny Smith, and I have an injury on my hands and arms and neck and head injury from car accident and previous injuries. I cannot run a weed eater, so I whacked the fruit tree really good when it was really young. So it's basically rootstock as well. And believe it or not, we do prune it. Goes out of control as soon as spring hits. Oh my gosh. This is so depressing. I can't even get up here to weed. This is an apricot row. And this apricot, which desperately needs pruning, was a gift. My husband got me a gift. I wanted a Moorpark apricot.